In today's episode, network video recorded from Dahua. So, stay tuned. If you like our tutorials, support our channel by clicking the subscribe button. Like and share our videos. And if our tutorials help you to grow your business, become a true member of Poseidon Tech by clicking the join button. If you want to learn more about our services, visit our website. Hello and welcome to Poseidon Tech. This is a network video recorder from Dahua. It comes in this box. This is the model number. Dahua NVR4216 belongs to Dahua's Lite series network recorders that supports 4K, 8265 encoding, 16 video channels, 2 hard disks, and 16 PoE network ports. More details you can find in dahuasecurity.com. Click on Products. Select Network Recorders. Click on Lite Series. 2 hard disks. And here it's the NVR4216. On the front panel of the NVR you will find the status indicator light, hard disk status, network status, power status, and a USB 2 port. On the rear panel you will find the power input port, power on-off button, rear fan, 16 PoE ports for the IP cameras, alarm output ports, VGA output port, HDMI port, USB port, RS-232 port, network port, audio output port, and audio input port. Let's check what else was inside the box. A quick start guide. Two SATA cables and two power SATA cables for the hard disks. A power cord. An Ethernet cable. Mounting screws for the hard disks and terminal connectors for the alarm output ports. And a USB mouse. Now it's time to install the hard disk. First, remove the 4 fixing screws on the rear panel. Remove the case cover. This is a 4TB Skyhawk Surveillance hard disk from Seagate. mounts the four holes on the baseboard to place the hard disk. Turn the device upside down. Match the screws with holes on the hard disk. And then fasten them. Connect the hard disk data cable and power cable to the device. Put back the cover and fasten the four screws on the rear panel to complete the installation. As you can see here, I have terminated all my IP cameras in a patch panel using Panduit's Minicom jack modules. For more details, please watch my step-by-step tutorial. I will put the NVR inside the rack. Now, I will connect every camera into NVR's PoE ports using patch cords. I will connect the NVR into my local network. Allow me to tidy up the patch cords inside the cable manager. I will connect also the power cord. Finally, I will turn on the NVR. Open a browser and type NVR's default IP address. Select your region. Select your language. Select video standard according to your region. Select your time zone. Click on Next. Accept the license agreement and click on Next. Give a strong password. Click on Next. Give your email address to be able to recover your password. If you want, you can give security questions and answers. I will skip this for now. Login using your password. This is NVR's dashboard. Click on Setting. Click on Network. Here you can modify the network settings of the NVR. I will give a static IP address according to my network settings. Click on Setting and Camera. Since I connected my DAHO IP cameras into PoE ports of the NVR, the cameras have been added automatically in the NVR. The IP addresses of the IP cameras have been assigned by the NVR. So now the cameras are accessible only from the NVR and not directly from your local LAN. Click on Camera Name. Here you can change the name of the camera that it will appear on live view or playbacks. When done, click OK. Click on Storage. Click on Disk Manager. To format the hard disk, select it and click on Format. To proceed, administrator password is required. Click on Schedule. The green bars here mean that all cameras will record every day 24 hours per day. These are the default record settings. I will show you in another video how to enable motion recording. From Settings, select System. Click on Date and Time. Here you can change your time settings. For example, I will change the date format to day, month, year. I will also enable NTP, Network Time Protocol, to ensure that my NVR will have always the correct time. The NTP server that I use is pool.ntp.org. From Setting, click on Account. I will add a user. Give a username and a password. Select Group. I will select User Group since I don't want to allow the user to access NVR settings. I will give permission to the user to access all cameras for playback and live view. From Setting, select Network. Click on P2P. For simplicity, I will use Dahua's cloud for remote access, so P2P must be enabled. Finally, click on Live to view live video. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next episode.